Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Ontario Aquaculture Research Center. I'm your host, Kaylee Moore, one of the agricultural assistants here at OARC. If you're looking to learn more about aquaculture, you're in the right place. On today's episode, we have Professor John Carter joining us to talk about the aquaculture program at Fleming College.
Hi guys, and welcome back. I'm super excited to have John Carter with us today. He's going to be discussing his current role that he is working in at Fleming College. So John, before we get started, maybe we can talk a little bit about yourself and what you guys are doing.
Yeah, I'm happy to talk about myself. It's what I know best. So I actually graduated from the University of Guelph way, way back. And the only company that I got a job with was an aquaculture company. I had no idea what aquaculture was. And here I am 26, 27 years later, still in aquaculture. So I did aquaculture in BC. I did salmon farming in British Columbia. I did restoration work with the Alberta government. I've done aquaculture pharmaceutical work with a pharmaceutical company on Prince Edward Island. And now teaching aquaculture at Fleming College for the last 6 years.
Awesome. I personally didn't take the aquaculture course at heard really good things about it. Graham from here took it, so I know he really enjoyed it. So because you're teaching the aquaculture co-op program at Fleming College, aquaculture involves a large range of activities related principally to farming, marine and freshwater fish and seafood. Can you outline how the aquaculture course will prepare students to enter the workforce?
Good question. So we actually, students in our program spend a lot of time in our on-campus hatchery. We have a hatchery on campus, and we treat that hatchery kind of like a workplace. So the students are actually treated that it's a workplace while they're learning. So they are hands-on for most of the course. So 12, 14 hours a week is actually working with fish in a hatchery setting. And then another 4 to 5 hours of lecture material. So we, like I say, treat it like a workplace, and students treat it like a workplace. We actually put them on call in second semester, and I will send them a fake alarm sometime during the week that they have to respond to and let me know how they're going to fix it. So yeah, it kind of gets them. I know when I got into aquaculture, I hadn't even thought about being on call. And it's one of those things that you really don't know what it's like until you experience it, that yeah, you can't go to a movie. Yeah, you can't be out for dinner or without some sort of escape plan to get to the facility if you need it. So we try and make it as real life as possible for the students, just to get them prepared for what they might expect in their careers.
No, and that's like, honestly, that's awesome. I went to a college. I went to Sioux College. I took the fish and wildlife program there, and getting that hands-on experience is really easy to go from, you know, school to workplace and really attach the knowledge and the hands-on experience to what exactly you're doing in the field. So it, I mean, having a hatchery on like on site is, you know, perfect, because coming here, I didn't know aquaculture myself, but I was able to take my field studies and apply certain things and just learn the experience. But I've never done on call either. So it's something I have to get used to. I have a kid, so I have to make sure I have people and everything around on those weekends when something happens. I mean, I've been super lucky so far, knock on wood, that I haven't had to do a lot of problem solving yet. But yeah, that's a big part of this industry for sure.
Yeah, you need to be kind of in that mindset, right? That I need to be able to get to the facility if I need to while I'm on the call. So
yeah,
it was something I wish I knew when I started.
Yeah, so the industry really is growing in all sectors. What are the different career opportunities for those who graduate from this program?
Well, like you say, there's all sorts of facets to aquaculture, you know, fish health, maintenance, management, and all sorts of different areas in maintenance. I've kind of started as a technician, and, you know, now I'm a professor and done all sorts of different. So one thing about aquaculture, there's all sorts of different routes you can go. And I've been very fortunate. I've always been able to follow what I found interesting. When I first started, I was really interested in sort of the fish health area. And my boss and I talked about that, and I became sort of a fish health biologist for the company. And that kind of led me into seeing how the hatchery operated, and I got interested in how water moved around in a land-based facility. So, and then from that interest came pharmaceutical and research and development. There's all sorts of different ways you can go. What I do tell my students, though, is you will probably have to start at the bottom. You need to know how the production cycle works. But having started at the bottom and getting some cycles under your belt and knowing what happens, you should be able to advance very quickly. I don't sort of give my students the idea that they're going to graduate from this program and become a director of freshwater or director of facilities. Even though they've taken this course, they still have to understand how the company itself operates. So
yeah, no, and that's super fair. I mean, fish studies, fish science specifically, I know it's super competitive. I came out of school and, for myself, I noticed that you really have to almost kind of be willing to go where the work is to get that experience. I'm from Southern Ontario and I went to school in Sault Ste. Marie, and then I went and worked in Timmins, Ontario, and then I was in South River. And so you have to be willing to kind of look for what you want and really put that effort in to get what you want. You're not just going to walk out and, exactly. Run the Ontario Aquaculture Research Center.
Exactly. No, yeah, exactly. And you made a very good point there too about going where the jobs are. Aquaculture is a global sort of industry. But unfortunately around Lindsay area, there's not a lot of aquaculture. So if you coming to Fleming College and living in the Peterborough, Lindsay area and hoping to stay in the Peterborough, Lindsay area and stay in aquaculture, that's going to be kind of tough. There's lots of opportunities in Ontario, but they're, Manitoulin Island or they're south of London. And so, you've got to be mobile is the way we put it, kind of first lecture. If you're willing to be mobile and go to different areas of Ontario or different areas of Canada or even different areas of the world, we've sent students to Tasmania. If you're willing to do that, then you can really, really excel.
That's amazing. And as like you said, there's lots of opportunities. Aquaculture is a fast-growing food production sector. Can you kind of tell us why you think aquaculture is an important industry?
The aquaculture, it's very sustainable. We've basically fished the commercial fisheries we're at maximum capacity. If you look, we haven't caught any more fish since 1995, 1996, and we can't keep treating the oceans like they're going to provide forever through wild fishing. There will always be commercial fisheries. But I think a partnership between commercial fisheries and aquaculture is the only way we'll be able to have a sustainable and increasing protein source for our growing population. I don't see how we do it without aquaculture, to be honest.
No, and that's simply put, you really, we need to keep feeding our population that's continuously growing. And I think this is an amazing industry that will only keep going up from here. I know you guys have recently received some funding to expand your current hatchery, which is exciting for your program. What are your plans for this expansion?
Well, you've done your homework. Yes, we did receive some money, and we are actually not going to expand our existing hatchery. We're going to build a new facility. And the goal of that facility is applied research. So industry would come to us with a problem that they're trying to solve. And we would work within that facility. So we still have the training facility for students, and then we would have an applied research facility for industry partners who have issues they're trying to fix or determine, and we would help them with that. And students could kind of merge back and forth between the two. It's a very exciting opportunity for our little aquaculture program. and we're really looking forward to it.
Yeah, that's super exciting because they'll get to see kind of like the, you know, the research aspect of it, but also like the food production side of things. Exactly. And how they both kind of meet in the middle. I think
that's perfect. That's exactly what we're trying to do, because aquaculture is not necessarily just food production. And also, it also shows what students get exposed to, what industry is trying to do to improve the aquaculture industry as a whole, whether it be feed or technology or growth rates, different strains. Like you say, the students being able to see that increase in research being put forth. When I started in aquaculture, it was kind of, you know, way back when you walked barefoot up the hill in the snowstorm. And we didn't do a lot of kind of trials and see what was best. We just fed fish and hope for the best, right?
Yeah.
And the way the technology's advanced, and we're hoping to be able to help facilitate that. So we're very excited about it. Very excited.
Yeah, I think for someone like me coming out, I was really interested in fish science. So I did the broad scale monitoring program with the MNRF. And aquaculture was never on my radar, like at all. And when I was on my maternity leave, I lived 12 minutes down the road from this place. Didn't even know this center here even hardly existed until someone had mentioned it to me. And I, you know, reached out to Marcia, and I came here and I thought, wow, this is like the experience of having both aquaculture and research together is really cool, because it's an industry that is growing and will be going somewhere bigger as the future goes, and having facilities like your new building will be just a bonus in this industry to help it keep growing, which is awesome.
Exactly.
So kind of my last question for you today, as the professor for the aquaculture program, do you have any advice to a future student who may be watching this today?
Good question. Yes. And we kind of touched a base on it a little bit. Be mobile. Don't get discouraged. You're going to be in this career, you're going to be cold, wet, and hungry sometimes, and you're going to be on call on Christmas Day and that kind of thing. But it was an accidental career for me, because like you, I really didn't know what aquaculture was, but it's been awesome. It's taken my family and I across the country. We've met great people in the industry, and the aquaculture industry, although it's global, is very small and tight-knit, and it's an awesome career. And if you are interested in aquaculture, definitely, whether it's through my program or through one of the other great programs offered in Canada, definitely pursue it. I've loved it. It's been an awesome career for me, provided for my family, and it's allowed us to make friends all across the country and visit places we never would have. So if fish and outdoors and that kind of thing is up your alley, definitely look into aquaculture.
Yeah, you couldn't really say it anymore. Couldn't say it better, really. You know, this is either for you or it's not. So
it's true. That is very true. And I, like I said, like you, didn't know what it was, but it's been great. I've loved it. Loved it. And now here I am getting to pass on my knowledge to other students. And you know, the best thing, they keep in touch. I stayed in a little motel in Port Alberni in the 90s in B.C., and one of my students took a picture of it and said, is this the motel you were talking about? And sent it to me. And it's just great seeing them doing what I was doing 30 years ago. It's amazing. Amazing.
No, perfect. I want to thank you, John, for joining me today and sharing with us about the aquaculture program, kind of a little bit about yourself and what you've done to get where you are, especially the positive effect that the Fleming program and your new facility that you guys are building, and the positive effect it's going to have on the aquaculture industry. So,
well, and I appreciate you taking the time to interview me. It's great. It's, you know, awesome. I really appreciate it.
No problem. Hey guys, I hope you liked the video today. If you did, please swim on over and hit the like button and subscribe. Comment below if you have any questions you want answered in any of our future videos. Hope to see you next time.